Good morning, friends. Today we will be discussing about the contemporary trends and critical issues in international tourism. So before I start, I'd like to ask you, what exactly is your understanding about international tourism? International tourism hota kya hai? Now let's first understand this term. All of you know what is inbound tourism. Inbound tourism means when the tourists come into your country, and outbound tourism signifies when tourists moves out of the country. So simply, when I talk about international tourism, means international tourism is now it's a summation of your inbound and the outbound tourism. Now this is a very simple definition of international tourism. Now, when I talk about international tourism, let's first understand ki puri duniya mein how many tourists are coming in, what is the total receipt collected from the international tourism. Now, as we know that tourism is one of the biggest industries in the world, and therefore tourism is able to generate a huge amount of money. And as per the statistics of 2010, tourism industry has collected about 919 billion tourism receipt in terms of USD. That is, this is the total collection, 919 billion USD was collected in year 2010. Now this was the total revenue collection, and if I talk about the total number of tourist arrivals in year 2010, so it's 940 million. Now, two very important statistics which are coming. One is the total receipt which is collected in year 2010, that is 919 USD. So, and the total number of tourists who have visited all over the world is 940 million tourists all over the world. Now let's understand which are the leading countries, which are the top countries who are generating or where tourists want to travel. Now first let's talk about this revenue which is collected. Now you will be wonderstruck, you will be surprised to know that majority of the countries which are there on the list are from the European part of the world. Number one on the list is United States. Now, United States account for 103 billion USD in year 2010, just imagine. Followed by Spain, then France, China, Italy, Germany, United Kingdom, Australia, Hong Kong and Turkey. Now, amongst this list of top 10, no, tourism receipt which is collected, now, we can well imagine that how bigger part European countries are playing in terms of the revenue collection. Now Spain, when I talk about Spain, France, no, Italy, United Kingdom, Turkey, all these countries, out of 10 top countries in the world, the total tourism receipt, we are having 5 countries from the European part of the world. We'll come down to the in the later stage that why and how Europe is able to generate or collect such a huge amount of revenue out of the tourism industry. Now let's have a look on the top 10 countries which are able to attract or the maximum number of tourist arrival. Now year 2010 has seen, again, the countries are from Europe itself. Amongst the top 10 countries, we are having 5 countries which are from Europe. First country which is leading the routes, which is on the top of the chart in terms of total tourist arrival, is France. Followed by United States, then is China, Spain, Italy, United Kingdom, Turkey, Germany, Malaysia and Mexico. Now, out of these 10 countries what we have listed out over here, the first country which is on the top of the chart is France. Now, all of you know that France, then is your Spain, Italy, all these countries are the Mediterranean countries. When we'll study about the European part of the world, we'll understand this thing, that these three countries have always been on the top of the chart. When I talk about, say, France, Spain and Italy. Now these three countries are always amongst the top 10 countries in the world which are having a maximum number of tourist arrivals. Now, a very simple question arises in our mind that how this Europe is able to generate such a huge amount of revenue and as well as the number of the tourists over there. Now, you will be surprised that Europe represents only 10% of the total world population. But even that, Europe is able to generate such a huge number of tourists over there, and definitely the revenue collection part. Now, globally, tourism industry has acquired significance. Now, as we have listed out here, Malaysia is at number 9 in terms of tourist arrival, if we go by the statistics of 2010. Now, Malaysia is a very small country and is able to attract 23.65 million foreign tourists. Malaysia, ki jo main baat karta hun, Malaysia, which is a very, very small country, is able to attract, is able to attract, say, about 23 million foreign tourists. 23 million. Now, on the other hand, in the last lecture, we have studied that India is able to attract only 5.58 million foreign tourists. Now, India, which represents 17% of the total world population, is able to generate only 5.58 million foreign tourists. On the other hand, a small country like Malaysia, which is just an equivalent of size of, say, Bihar or any other small state of India, is able to generate 23 million foreign tourists. Now, let's understand why there is so much of difference, why there is so much of a change of the tourists, and definitely the revenue collection. Now, some of the countries, their total economy is based on the tourism industry itself. Like we talk about Malaysia, we talk about, say, Singapore, Thailand, these small countries are totally banking on the tourism industry. Now, it talks about the potential tourism industry is having. Now, this is all good about tourism industry, but definitely, every coin has two sides. This is one of the parts of tourism industry, but if we talk about the other part of tourism industry, as the tourism industry has developed, it has actually amounted a lot of challenges. It is facing a lot of challenges and issues, which is related to tourism industry. Now, tourism industry, all of us know that tourism industry is one of the most sensitive industries in the world. It is affected by small little changes. Either that is the inflation happening anywhere in the world, terrorism attacks happening anywhere in the world, so directly it is affected, it affects the tourism industry. Now, first and foremost challenge, which is there, slide number one. Now, first and foremost challenge what tourism industry is facing is the economic impact and leakage from the tourism. Now, economic impact, jab main kehta hun, economic impact ka matlab ho gaya. Now, this is very much true that we are able to attract, we are able to generate more than 900 billion USD from tourism industry. But on the other hand, there is one very sensitive issue which we have to deal with. And this is one of the challenges. Wherever tourism industry has flourished, any country we talk about, now there is a problem of economic leakage and the economic impact on the tourism industry. Now, this tourism industry has become a very, very easy punching bag for the, say, drug peddlers, black money laundering, and floating of fake currencies and all. We have seen DAOs and a lot of terrorist groups which are coming and constructing a lot of hotels all over the world. Now, this is one of the challenges. How can this deal be done? On the one hand, we want to develop the infrastructure, but on the other hand, people who are coming in, they are coming in with their black money, they are floating their black money into the market and giving it the name of tourism industry. Now, this is one of the challenges tourism industry has to deal with. Now, amongst the 21 challenges what WTTC has listed out, this is number one challenge for the tourism industry. How to deal with this particular challenge? Now, second and very important challenge which tourism industry is dealing, contemporary challenge if I talk about. Dekhi, jab main contemporary ki baat karta hun, contemporary simply means at this point of time, living in the same age, aaj ke time mein humare ko aur challenges kya hain. Second, and very important challenge is the safety and security. Now, safety is one of the biggest concerns for the tourism industry. Now, we have seen that 9/11 attacks, we have seen 36/11, we have seen every day somewhere in the world these attacks, bomb blasts are happening, and directly it is directly affecting the tourism industry itself. We have seen initially people used to talk about that Asia is only one part of the world which is badly affected by the tourism industry. But now case has changed. Now terrorism attacks are happening all over the world. Now people are not even safe in London city. They are not safe in United Kingdom. They are not safe in USA or any part of the world. Now centers like Mediterranean are also affected by the tourism attacks. Leave apart the picture of Asia. Yes, Asia is one of the biggest. No, Asia is affected by this problem, that is safety and security. Talking in particular about India, India, which is one of the biggest countries in the Asian part of the world, after China, of course. But why we are not able to come up with the tourism industry in India? We are just able to attract 5.58 million foreign tourists over here. Now this is one of the challenges. When people perceive about tourism in India, they actually, replicate this thing. They actually, when we talk about India, the first impression for the European or the Western part of the world is, okay, this part of the world is very badly affected by the terrorism. And of course this is true also. We are having neighborhood of Pakistan, Afghanistan, we are having Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. Now all these countries which we call ASEAN group also, or SAR countries also, which are neighboring India, are one way or the other is affected by the terrorism. Now terrorism is one of the problem which we have to deal with. Now question here is, ki is problem ko deal kaise kiya jaye? Now first and foremost thing we need to understand over here is that when anybody moves out from this place, his or her place, we are first and foremost concerned about our safety and security. Hamare liye sabse pehla concern hota hai ki are we safe? We are spending so much amount of money, so are we safe when we are moving towards any of the destinations? Now if the answer is yes, now that will be the preferred destination for a tourist. If the answer is no, then we are not the preferred destination for that particular group of the client who wants to travel, who wanted to travel to a particular place. Now safety and security ko hum deal kaise karein, this particular challenge ko hum kaise deal karein at this point of time? Now strict visa measures is one of the things. A lot of countries are implying. Then some of the countries has come up with the concept of tourism police. Now we should have a good relationship with our neighbors. That is very, very important for the tourism industry. If we do not have the, if we are having a neighborhood like, why there is a huge number of tourists who are traveling in Europe itself? The answer is very simple, that they are having a very, very good relationship with the neighboring countries, and people are traveling within the region itself. In Europe, if we understand the geography of Europe, if we talk about say northern part of the Europe, now European northern part of the Europe is what you call a Nordic countries, or we also call them countries what you call a Scandinavian countries, which are Norway, Finland, Sweden, Denmark and all. Now these countries are very, very close to the North Pole. Therefore geographically this particular part of Europe is very cold and frigid in nature. But when we come down the central part of the Europe, you are having countries like say Germany, you have countries like Luxembourg and all. Now this particular part of the world has seen the industrial revolution. And not only industrial revolution, it has seen other revolutions also, like your intellectual revolution. If you talk about, if we just move down towards Europe, southern part of the Europe, you will see countries like Spain, you are having countries like Italy, Portugal, you are having all these countries over there, Greece, Now these countries which are on the Mediterranean coast of the Europe is called south part of the Europe. Now geographically Europe is located in such a fashion that the northern part is totally frigid zone. The central part of Europe is the economic zone of the Europe, the heartline, or you can say the where you are having the maximum industrial plants over there. Then if you move down towards southern part of Europe, You have in countries like Spain, which is having a beautiful, beautiful coastline. Italy. No, you talk about France. All these countries over there. Therefore, when you're having, and you will be surprised to know that Europe, traveling in Europe, you need only one visa. Majority of the countries, 20, more than 20 countries, that is called Schengen visa. You require only one visa when you are traveling in Europe. You can, on one visa, you can travel more than 20 countries. How wonderful that is. It means that these countries are having very, very good relationships with each other and having a very, very conducive atmosphere, very favorable atmosphere for the tourists who is coming in. And they actually are a very, very safe destination all over the world. Therefore, they are number one in terms of tourist arrivals and tourism receipts also. But let's take a case of Asia. Now in Asia, what has happened over here is that though Malaysia, countries like Malaysia, Thailand, Singapore, they have come out in a huge way to attract tourists over here. But when we talk about India, when we talk about Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Bangladesh, all these countries are not able to come up with a common agenda, common platform, common thing, which can actually encourage tourists who are coming into the country. We are having a common cultures to share. Like if you talk about, say, Pakistan, if you talk about Nepal, if you talk about Sri Lanka, we have a lot of things in common. But yet, we are not able to come up with some single policy or single, say, regulation which can actually boost up tourism. Talk about borders also. Now, borders are not very safe. If you are traveling from, say, Nepal to India, now this, all of us know that this is not one of the, this is the safest heaven for the, yes, terrorists, but not for the tourists. Talk about India and Pakistan. Here also you are having a very, very, volatile neighborhood, a very sensitive borders over there. We talk about India, Sri Lanka, again there is a problem. If you talk about India, Bangladesh, again there is a problem. Now therefore we need to understand that if we want to come up, if we want to come up as a country, as a region, in terms of tourists, attracting tourists, we need to solve this problem. We need to handle this problem in a very, very significant fashion. Now, there is extension. Now, third important challenge is extension of influence of US throughout the travel and tourism industry. Now, this is very important and very interesting also. When you talk about US influence, now when we talk about, say, multinational companies, now you will see that majority of the companies, multinational companies who have come into the India are from US. You talk about any excellent 5-star hotel chains, they are from US. You talk about any of the brands or any of the, say, cruise liners, any of the movies which are the biggest hits, they are from the US. Now, influence of US, now how this is a challenge, now this is a big question. Now, challenge in a sense that whatsoever US actually, depicts or showcases to the world, that is taken as a last word. Now, I'll give you an example on that. Now, US actually, when US gives an impression that Asia, in their movies, when they give an impression that Asia or Africa is are the continents which are very badly affected by, say, epidemics, with the diseases, with terrorism and all that. So, people conceive that particular, region in that particular fashion itself. Now, US is definitely having a leadership or they are having a definitely a very, very superiority over number of things. They are one of the biggest funding agencies to the UN. Therefore, in any of the policy making, you talk about any of the air regulation, any of the safety and security regulations, the US is the one who is ruling the roost. They are ruling everybody. That things has to be like this. Now this challenge has to deal with. Now Europe to some extent is able to counter this particular challenge. They have developed a different currency to break down the hegemony, to break down the, this particular US ki ek pura pura influence hai, so totally what Europe has done. Europe has come up with a common currency, which is what? Called Euro. Now Euro is a currency which they have come up with, ki Europe mein jitna bhi transaction hoga, majority of the countries are member of Eurozone. Now jitna bhi transaction hota hai, trade hota hai Europe mein, wo in terms of Euro hi hota hai. But let's take an example of Asia. Come back to Asia again. Now, for the ages, for the last, I don't know, 16, 17 summits in SAARC itself, we are discussing about to come up with a, say, common currency for the SAARC region, but we are not able to come up with a single currency, as if not. Now, as a continent, as a region, we need to understand that if we keep on depending on one particular region, on one particular country, we will not be able to develop at any point of time. At some point of time, we have to come up with our common agendas, common currencies, maybe common things where we can develop, which actually encourage, which actually boost up the tourism industry in the country or in the region. Now, this is one of the problems to be solved. Another important challenge is impact of globalization. Now, globalization, all of you understand, what exactly is globalization? Globalization means, in the words of Lord Buddha, Vasudev Kutumbakam, कि सारा संसार ही एक छोटे एक गांव की तरह है. नाउ विद द एडवेंट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, जैसे आप लोगों ने देखा कि टेक्नोलॉजी का एडवांसमेंट हुआ, नो विद द एडवांसमेंट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, साइंस एंड ऑल, नाउ दिस होल वर्ल्ड हैज बिकम अ वेरी वेरी स्मॉल विलेज. नाउ इन टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री व्हाट वी नीड इज अमाउंट ऑफ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ मनी. देन यू इफ यू हैविंग सफिशियंट टाइम यू कैन ट्रेवल एट एनी पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. बट दिस वॉज नॉट द केस. If you talk to your grandparents and if you talk, tell them, okay, I will be traveling America tomorrow, at their age, it's not possible. Because at that point of time, there was a lot of paucity, there was a lot of scarcity of the technological part, there were no frequent flights, what we see today, So, aaj jo hai, traveling bahut asaan ho chuki hai. Like, there are a number of flights which are operating from New Delhi every day to USA also. You are having different channels, mode of transportation available, So, what you need is sufficient money and the time itself. Now, globalization has brought up a lot of challenges also. इससे हमारे को फायदे बहुत सारे हुए, लेकिन साथ ही साथ में हमारे कुछ नुकसान भी हुए. ग्लोबलाइजेशन के साथ ही हुआ क्या कि जैसे जैसे डेवलपमेंट हुई, नाउ टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री हैज फेस लॉट ऑफ चैलेंजेस, कॉम्पिटिशन. नाउ ग्लोबलाइजेशन हो गया, लोगों ने ट्रेवल करना शुरू कर दिया. नाउ लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ इंडिया. इफ इंडिया विल नॉट बी एबल टू रेज द प्रॉपर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर द टूरिस्ट हु आर कमिंग इन, इफ वी आर नॉट एबल टू हैंडल द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ से सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी ओवर हियर इन कंट्री, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, दैट द टूरिस्ट वांट टू ट्रेवल, दैट इज फॉर श्योर. But tourists will travel to some other destination which is offering them a good amount of infrastructure, good amount of safety and security, and of course the leisure facilities of leisure and the places they want to see. Now that is one of the challenges what globalization has brought to the tourism industry. Fifth challenge for the tourism industry is the greater liberalization of visas. Now visa, when I talk about visa, all of you know that visa is one of the documents which is required. Now, visa, when I talk about visa, if I just elaborate this term, this is your visitor's intended staying abroad. If I just elaborate this term, this is your visitor intended staying abroad. Now, one of the challenges tourism industry is facing today is liberalization of visas. On one hand, we are facing the problem of terrorism. We are facing the problem of, say, safety and security. But on the other hand, this is one of the challenges for any tourist destination to come up with a liberalized policy of the visa norms. But ये होगा कैसे? Now this is one of the biggest questions. एक तरफ तो हमारे को safety and security भी tight करनी है. We want to be one of the safest destination on this planet. But on the other hand, the challenge is that to liberalize the visa norms. हम liberalize करेंगे visas तो अगर देखिए बहुत simple है कि अगर visa processes बहुत ज़्यादा red tapeism होगा, उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा official work involved होगा, बहुत time consuming होगा, तो वो जो हमारी visa policy, it will discourage the tourist to travel to a particular country. Therefore, people have come up with the concepts like on the arrival visa. Thailand की बात करते हैं. Thailand में काफी time तक they initiated one of the programs on the arrival visa. आप अपने documents के साथ अपना बैंक की पासबुक लेके, अपना सैलरी स्टेटमेंट लेके, ठीक है, मिक्स अमाउंट ऑफ मनी और डॉक्यूमेंट्स कंप्लीट करके जाइए, एंड ऑन दी नो एयरपोर्ट इटसेल्फ यू विल गेट योर वीजा.
नो, वेरी सिंपल.
ऑन दी अदर हैंड, अगर हम अपना वीजा को बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट कर देंगे, उसके अंदर बहुत सारी फॉर्मेलिटीज टेक्निकलिटीज इन्वॉल्व कर देंगे, तो वो बात क्या, इट विल डिस्करेज द टूरिस्ट्स कमिंग ओवर देयर. Now here, please understand, there is a very, very, very important question over here. It is that on one hand we are talking about safety and security. Agar hum liberalize kar denge, ab jaise country like India, we cannot afford to have the liberalization of visas. Agar hum liberal, aap sabko batayenge USA mein kitne zyada strict visa law hai. Yesterday what has happened over there? Now Dr. A.B.J. Abul Kalam, he was traveling on the boat. Now, he was actually, twice, unki checking ki gayi on board bhi. Now, they are having very, very strict way of handling things over there. Even if you are having valid visa over there. Safety and security is one of the biggest concerns. Lekin country like India, jahan par humare paas jo neighborhood hai, bahut hi zyada humare hostile hai. Us country mein humare ko ek taraf ka tourism bhi अट्रैक्ट करना है, टूरिज्म को बूस्ट अप करना है, दूसरी तरफ हमारे पास चैलेंजेस हैं, हर दिन हमारे पास हर महीने दूसरे तीसरे महीने ब्लास्ट होते रहते हैं, तो यहां पर लिबरलाइज करके वीजा ये हेल्प करेगा या हमारे को और ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट कर देगा, ये हमारे को क्वेश्चन आंसर करना है. नाउ वेरी सिंपल थिंग टू डू ओवर हियर इज दैट हैविंग अ एप्रोप्रिएट सेफ्टी मेजर एट द एयरपोर्ट्स ऑल एंड ऑल द चेकिंग पॉइंट्स एंड टू सेंसिटाइज द पब्लिक. हमारे कोई पब्लिक अवेयरनेस कैंपेन बहुत जरूरी है. देखिए, अगर आप यूरोप जाएंगे कभी या फिर आप साउथ ईस्ट एशिया जाएंगे, वहां देखेंगे आप कि पब्लिक इतनी अवेयर है जो टूरिस्ट आता है उसके बारे उसके उसके प्रति. हमारे को सेंसिटाइज करना पड़ेगा पॉपुलेशन को, लोकल कम्युनिटी को. हमारे को अपनी जो सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी की जो हमारे लोग काम कर रहे हैं उनको अपडेटेड हमारे गैजेट्स प्रोवाइड करने पड़ेंगे, जिससे सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी के हमारे स्टैंडर्ड बहुत हाई हो जाए जहां पर तो ये कुछ चीजें हैं. और लिबरलाइजेशन ऑफ वीजा इज मस्ट. कोई भी कंट्री, कोई भी कॉन्टिनेंट बिना लिबरलाइज किए हुए वीजा को आज सर्वाइव नहीं कर सकती है टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री में. फॉर द सिंपल रीजन, क्योंकि कॉम्पिटिशन इतना बढ़ चुका है ग्लोबलाइजेशन के कारण कि आप अगर अपने वीजा नॉर्म्स को बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट कर देंगे तो टूरिस्ट ने तो ट्रेवल करना ही है, वो आपकी कंट्री में ना जाके किसी और कंट्री में ट्रेवल करेगा. दिस इज वन ऑफ द चैलेंजेस टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री इज फेसिंग. एंड there are other challenges. I will take up the last challenge for what WTTC has listed out, that is taxation. देखिए, I'll give an example of say Kullu and Manali. Taxation की जब मैं बात करता हूँ, now taxation is one of the problems what tourism industry is facing today. कोई भी destination एक बहुत बड़ा destination, एक tourist destination बन जाता है, तो होता क्या है? Let's take an example of India, no? Now you would be surprised to know that shooting अगर करनी हो आपको, किसी movie की shooting करनी हो, serial की shooting करनी हो आपको, तो मनाली, कुल्लू एंड मनाली या फिर गोवा में shooting करना ज्यादा expensive है than doing a shooting in say Singapore or the Malaysia. Now how come that is? Now multiple taxation. हमने क्या किया हुआ है यहाँ इंडिया में कि we have all sort of taxes. We have road tax, we have toll tax, we have this tax, that tax. And on the top of it, destination which acquired some bit of name in the tourism industry, we apply another tax over there, that is entertainment tax. Now on the other hand, let's take an example. This is one of the cases in India. Let's take an example of United Kingdom. UK government ne ek special regulation policy bana rakhi hai taxation ke upar ki jo bhi log किसी भी कॉर्नर से यूके में मूवी को शूट करने आएंगे तो 50% उनके क्रू मेंबर्स को, उनके जितने भी मेंबर्स होंगे पूरे के पूरे डेलीगेशन के अंदर, उनको 50% रिलैक्सेशन दिया जाएगा होटल्स पे, एयरलाइंस पे और जहां भी वो ट्रेवल करते हैं. नाउ दैट विल डेफिनेटली एनकरेज टूरिस्ट गोइंग ओवर देयर. अगर आज हम सिनेमैटिक टूरिज्म की बात करते हैं, सिनेमैटिक टूरिज्म मीन्स सिनेमा जो एक टूरिज्म प्रमोट कर रहा है उसको हम सिनेमैटिक टूरिज्म कहते हैं. आप लोगों ने देखा होगा ऋतिक रोशन को a few years back, New Zealand government has actually gave honor to Hrithik Roshan for his first movie. Why is that? Why they have given that honor to Hrithik Roshan? Anybody can answer that? Now, very simple thing is that why they have honored Hrithik Roshan, that with the help of his movie, he is able to project a very, very good image of New Zealand amongst masses over here. मीडिया अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़ा रोल प्ले करता है टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री के लिए। किसी मूवी में अगर कोई डेस्टिनेशन दिखाया जाए तो उसको अलग से पब्लिसिटी की जरूरत नहीं रह जाती है, वो ऑटोमेटिकली एक टूरिस्ट डेस्टिनेशन या फिर एक फेवरेट डेस्टिनेशन बन जाता है किसी टूरिस्ट जो भी वहां जाता है। नाउ दिस वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द टैक्सेशन इज वन ऑफ द थिंग्स व्हिच वी नीड टू लिबरलाइज फॉर द टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री। अगर वी लिबरलाइज इट, अगर हम टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री को ऐसा समझ लेंगे ओके दिस इज वन ऑफ द इंडस्ट्रीज व्हिच इज चर्निंग अप लॉट ऑफ मनी और इसमें और टैक्सेस लगा दीजिए और ज्यादा टैक्सेस लगा दीजिए तो व्हाट विल हैपन, दिस विल बी लाइक अ काउ, एक गाय की तरह बन जाएगी जिससे हम रोज दूध निकाल रहे हैं लेकिन हम उसको अच्छी तरह से फीडिंग नहीं कर रहे हैं। सो इफ वी रियली वॉन्ट टू हैव अ मिल्क फॉर एवर वी हैव टू फीड दैट काउ प्रॉपरली सो दैट वी कैन चर्न आउट मनी एंड वेल्थ विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम। सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे एंड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अदर चैलेंजेस, व्हाट आर द अदर इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यूज। आप लोग सोचिएगा आज टूरिज्म इंडस्ट्री, आज टूरिज्म के संदर्भ में, आज जब हम टूरिज्म की बात करते हैं और हमारे पास क्या चैलेंजेस हैं। वन ऑफ द चैलेंजेस इज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, बहुत सारे चैलेंजेस आपको देखने को मिलेंगे, पॉवर्टी इज वन ऑफ द चैलेंजेस, सोशल एस्पेक्ट, सोशल इश्यूज हैं आज बहुत सारे, आप सोच के आइएगा एंड देन विल डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर व्हाट आर द अदर चैलेंजेस, व्हाट WBDC हैज मिस्ड आउट। थैंक यू।